All right, so what I wanted to do in this video is actually share with you how to mirror an iPad into Blackboard. Something that I always wanted to do, and I was looking around trying to see how I can figure this thing out. So what I will do is I'll show you the steps to do that, and I will also show you how I set up Blackboard to try to run a full out session with students, and hopefully it will help you and maybe give you some ideas how you can run a full out online class pretty much the same way as you would run a regular class. So I hope that you find this useful. All right, so the first thing that we'll do is we will plug in the iPad, okay, that you see into the computer. All right, so that's the first step that we'll do. So here it is, okay, so we're gonna be plugging it in. Now, once it's plugged in, we'll go to the next step is, and we're gonna need to load up our QuickTime player. Okay, so now the second component, let's try to take the iPad, and now once we have loaded it up, let's load up QuickTime Player. So I'm gonna do it, so right from the applications, just so that you can see the whole thing, in case you don't have your QuickTime Player. So you're gonna have to go to applications, scroll around, look for QuickTime Player. So mine's right here. Let me just open this up. And now once QuickTime Player loads, I wanna minimize this. So you will only see QuickTime Player just on top here. So QuickTime Player and the file. Okay, so we'll open this up and then we're gonna hit new movie recording. So now the new movie recording, so what we have, okay, so notice I am mirroring my iPad. So my iPad is now being projected onto the screen, which is exactly what I wanted to do. Now, how do you do that? Okay, so if you go right here, notice that typically what will happen is, so it's gonna be on your FaceTime camera, so it's something like that. So now you're seeing me in a couple of different places. And that particular camera, what you do want is you wanna be able to switch it to your iPad. So now it's Bartek's iPad, and of course you will have your iPad here. Now be careful, because when I first started this, my iPad actually didn't appear. And I had to kind of unplug and plug in a couple of times to see it. And then also on the first time, it actually asks you if you want to trust the computer and so on if you haven't plugged it in before. So just be aware of that. So now as I switch over to the iPad again, okay, so notice it's just waiting and waiting, and now there it is. All right, so this is just a quick note. If your iPad is not connecting, okay, so watch the video. I'm putting an iCard there, a link on some of the things that I have done to fix that problem, because it may happen that your iPad will not connect through QuickTime. This is an Apple problem, and hopefully they'll solve it in the future. It doesn't happen for everybody, but I know that it happens enough because through research and my own experience, I have run into that, okay? So you can click that card and watch it. Okay, let's get back to our video. Cheers. Okay, so far I showed you how to connect the iPad to the Mac. You can do it the same way to a laptop. Now, once you connect it, we had to load QuickTime Player in order to mirror the iPad so it is displayed on the screen. I have actually removed it now from the screen, so that I can show you the next step. Okay, so my screen is actually minimized for the iPad, and all you're seeing right now on the screen is just Blackboard Collaborate. So we don't just wanna be able to mirror the iPad on our screen, we wanna be able to share that screen with our students so that our students are able to see that actual iPad. So how do we do that? Well, so in Blackboard Collaborate, you have, okay, so I'm gonna load this up, is your regular chat that you see with students. There's obviously no students here because I'm just doing a demo. You can see who's there, and then you can share content. Now, when you're sharing content, you can share a whiteboard, or you can share your entire screen. I am using Safari because I'm using the Apple products. Now, with Safari, okay, so once I hit this application of sharing the screen, I am asked, are you sure you want to do that? So I will allow it. Now, it takes a little bit of time, but notice, now this is what the students would see. Now, I don't want students to see this mirroring of my screen, and obviously it just goes one, two, and just keeps going. I want to be able to share with them all the applications on my screen, but without this junk. So what I do is, okay, I basically will just take this and then shift this over so that they do not see it. And then I'll just put it on the chat in case I still want to see if they are chatting with me. And now the remainder of the screen, so all of this area and so on, I will then use that area in order to populate it with my iPad. So through the QuickTime player, I will just load it up and it's going to be displayed, okay, right beside. So it's going to be displayed here, and then any other application. Sometimes I like to put an agenda here, and then sometimes I like to put, okay, just as you guys are seeing me here at the bottom corner, I also sometimes want them to see that in the bottom corner. All right, so that's how you share your entire screen. Okay, in the next step, I will now populate my screen so that you can see which applications I use. And then I will show you exactly what the students are seeing. Okay, so this is now the next step. So now we have seen how to hook up the iPad, how to, you know, launch QuickTime Player, and then how to share the whole screen with your students, okay, so on Blackboard. Now, I want to bring those things together, and I just want to show you how I lay out the screen, because the next kind of section that you'll see is you're going to just see Blackboard, and then everything is going to be laid out on the screen what students see. So I want to show you how I actually do that kind of from scratch. So you're not seeing me at the moment, and so there's a reason for that, because I want to just show you exactly what students might see from my screen. So in applications, the first thing that I'll launch is a photo booth. Now, a photo booth is pretty nice because you can launch it up, it hooks up to your camera, and then you can resize it how you please. So depending, you know, how big you want to be and whatever that may be for your students. So I'm going to leave this at the moment. Okay, so now you see me there. Now, the next thing that I like to do is on my screen when I am actually teaching anything or running anything with anybody, I always like to provide an agenda. And now, so I'm actually here, it's Microsoft Word document. It doesn't have to be, it can be any editing tool. And I kind of set the agenda. I always, when I teach, I always like to have the agenda right there so everybody knows exactly what we're covering and where we're at. So, I mean, I didn't fill out this agenda in any way, but you can imagine that this is something that might be useful. Okay, so this is what I do. And now I'll resize this image here of myself a little bit like that. Okay, so this is kind of on the right-hand side of the image. So the next item that I'll try to do is I'm gonna try to load up here the QuickTime Player. Okay, so let's load this up. Okay, and so new movie recording. All right, okay, so here is my iPad. Okay, so that's hooked up. And then I'm gonna resize it. Now again, remember, so if you just as a deja vu, you have to pick your iPad from the cameras that your QuickTime Player is displaying. Okay, so this is exactly what my screen looks like, and now I get to interact with students. And what you see, now this actually, this was loaded because it was a video that I did on what an index fund is. I did it for my daughter. As a teacher investing, in any case, that's kind of how I lay out my entire screen. Okay, so this is what it's done. And then so students would see something like this, and then, you know, they'll see me working on the iPad throughout, they'll see me in the corner at the bottom, you know, if they want a visual of me, and then they'll see the agenda, which I might point out to here on and off. All right, now, this app that I'm actually using because I get to write on it, Okay, so fold out. Okay, so for instance, you know, I can write on this. It's notability, but you can use pretty much anything. Again, remember that the beauty with the iPad and projecting it out, that you can project out anything. You know, you can project out, so I can bring out, you know, here is a calculator. If I'm teaching them some math class, you know, and I need some quick calculations, so they'll see that. And that's the beauty of this. You can put your Excel sheets there if you want to, you know, flip back and forth between that, whatever it is that you're using. You know, you can go on the internet if you like and then search there. So they'll just see this entire image. All right, let's go to the next step, okay, where you will see now Blackboard exactly displaying. Well, maybe not exactly displaying this. I might put some different presentation there, but that's how it will look like. Okay, cheers. So now next, what you're seeing on the screen is exactly what students would see from me. Okay, so when I am doing this, okay, I am, you know, working on the actual iPad, and they're seeing everything that I am actually working on. So notice, you know, I can, you know, write out here. Okay, so as I write on the screen, you know, they also see that on the screen. If I had to do, for instance, any application within the iPad, what's beautiful about this is that they're able to see exactly what I have, and I don't have to keep switching back and forth between applications, and they're able to see this on their screen. So whatever it is, if it's calculator, I wanna be able to show them. If I want to be able to, you know, flip between different applications, okay, you know, you can have all kinds of different applications that you have on yours, and you can interact with them, and you can imagine, you know, how powerful this is and what they actually see. So they're constantly seeing, you know, my iPad, and I get to interact with them. Now, the more that you put on your screen, you know, the more trouble you may have, because obviously it's going through the internet. So what you see now is you see what they are seeing, and there is a little bit of lag, right? But if you don't have maybe the camera, if you don't have some other applications running, it does get way better. All right, so I guess this is it of the video. Okay, so thank you for watching. I hope that you found this useful. All right, okay, so cheers.